So this whole question of digital literacy, so it's a process of maturity. So for example, if I take Uttarakhand and I'm building something there over 100 acres, the first thing I did was got a fiber tunnel. Even before we started the building, said okay, like Devang Mehta used to say, roti, kapda, makan, and internet. So it's that basic.
He has solved one paradigm, at least access is important, and he's also spoken about skills. So before I go back to Ranjan later on, we'll talk about literacy and skill development, etc. Mohit, there are two things. Do you agree with what Ranjan says? And secondly, if you have some examples to access?
So I think very quickly, just so that we are running short of time, inclusion, according to me, is basically three things. One is access for everyone, second is relevance, and third is the skills there. Now, access, I think in today's times, really, there could be a better time to talk about the relevance of digital inclusion. If everyone was included, we wouldn't have had the crisis because of demonetization. Look at how many people have access to technology, which can make us a cashless society. It is, does everyone have a smartphone? Does everybody have access to broadband internet? Can everyone afford broadband internet? At Google, for example, we are running a lot of initiatives because we do feel that the more which people come online, there are 350 million Indians which have access to internet today, but we are a 1.2 billion people, almost a billion more to go. Right, and with just these many people, we are the second largest internet population in the world. So stuff like we are doing the railway Wi-Fi project where we'll bring in Wi-Fi to 400 stations. We've just done 53 so far. And